Dear attendants, my name is Juan Carlos Martín Torrijos. I am colonel of the Spanish Air Force. In this period, we will analyze the evolution of the security from the point of view of Spain mainly, with a reflection with the evolution parallel in the Western Europe. As you can see in this slide, first we will talk about the different meanings of security and defense, following by the evolution of these two concepts in the national security concept. Next, we will show how security challenges are being faced in this early 21st century, with a brief particular analysis of the Spanish case. Next, we will summarily analyze the current Spanish National Security Strategy 2017. Finally, I will present some brief conclusions. The end of the Second World War curved the expansion of fever, mainly represented by Germany and Japan. Since the second half of the 20th century, politicians have preferred to speak to defense, only to refer to the protection of interests of citizens, mainly beyond the national borders. But alongside the external threat, there is also internal threat, mainly derived from Ukrainian political conflicts. In Spain, the situation had its administrative threat with the existence of two ministries, the Ministry of Internal Affairs, Interior, to manage the police forces, and the Ministry of Defense to manage the defense and the military affairs. At legal level, this situation has its reflection with the approval of the Law 6/1980, nowadays on work, which regulates the basic criteria of the national defense and the military organization. This law defines national defense as the willingness, integration, and coordinated action of all the energies and moral and material forces of the nation face of any form of aggression, but no, doesn't yet refer to the term security. Thus, security and defense are concepts that in theory at that time were juxtaposed. But this differentiation was too artificial. The need to coordinate all types of peacekeeping efforts quickly became clear, giving way to only one term, security and defense. In June 1999, the European Union decided to develop the European Security and Defense Policy, later renamed Common Security and Defense Policy, in order to ensure that the European Union had the appropriate structures and capabilities, including the military, for conflict prevention and crisis management. At the Spanish level, this change was reflected 3 years later with the approval of the National Defense Directive 1/2004. The main goal of this document was to promote in Spain a genuine European security and defense policy. According to it, Spain wanted to contribute to the European defense, equipping with itself with the necessary civil and military capabilities. In conclusion, in Spain, as in the others of the European Union, the 21st century has brought by the hand the already undissoluble union of the two concepts, security and defense. The terrorist attack on 7/11/2001 were a key event in changing the global strategic landscape. Global threats expanded to include crime and transnational terrorism. This situation was reflected in Spain with the publication of the aforementioned National Defense Directive 1/2004 and a new one in 2008. In which global risks such as food, energy, water, natural resources, or climate change are beginning to be taken into consideration. And non-state actors, as crime networks, transnational companies, or religious organizations, are beginning to have a great weight. At legal level, the concept included in the National Directive 1/2004 was reflected by the approval of the Law 5/2005 on national defense, which already defines the purpose of the defense policy as the protection of the whole of the Spanish society, of its constitution, the super values, principles, and institutions, the social and democratic rule of law, and the full exercise of rights and freedoms, and the independence and the territorial integrity of Spain. In addition, this law created the National Defense Council as an advisory body of the president of the government, as you know, the Spanish prime minister, in matters in national defense. The members of the Council are the President of the Government, who presides it, the Vice Presidents, the Minister responsible for defense, internal affairs, foreign affairs, economy and finance, the Chief of the Defense Staff, the Chief of the Staff of the Army, Navy and the Air Force, the director of the National Intelligence Center and the director of the cabinet of the president of the government. In the beginning of the present decade, in 2011, the first Spanish security strategy was approved. It is considered a milestone in the history of strategic planning thinking in Spain. This document considers the appropriate combination of military and civilian means, and it appears a new concept, coordination between state, public administration, companies, and social organizations. In 2013, a new national security strategy was approved, which offered a comprehensive vision of security, expressly declaring the necessary citizen participation. Possible, the most important innovation in this document was the creation of the National Security Council, but doesn't replace the National Defense Council. The National Security Council is a delegated commission of the government at the maximum body of the state in matters of national security. Not there is no talk, nor of defense, nor of security and defense concept that are integrated in another broader concept, national security. The members of this council are the president of the government, who presides it, the vice presidents, the minister responsible for presidency affairs, foreign affairs, justice, defense, finance, internal affairs, development, industry, commerce and tourism, relations with the parliament, economy, health, consumption and social welfare. The general director of the cabinet of the president of the government, the secretaries of state for foreign affairs and security, the chief of defense staff, the director of the National Intelligence Center, and the director of the Homeland Security Department. With the new approach, Law 36/2015 was approved. Summary, this law defines the concept of national security as the action of the state aimed to protecting the freedom and rights of citizens, guaranteeing the defense of the country. Also, it made clear that the national security policy includes the defense of Spain and the contribution to the international security. This law also says that the national security strategy is the main political framework of the national security policies, and this must be approved by the Council of Ministers every 5 years, or sooner if strategic circumstances advise it. The first national security strategy was approved in 2017, and the National Security Council intervened in it, preparing together with a committee of more than 50 experts coming from various fields. Now we will analyze the current national security strategy approved in 2017. Introduction. National security is described in a comprehensive way and conceived as a public service and object of the state action. National defense, public security and foreign action are fundamental components of the national security, supported by the intelligence and information services of the state. Chapter 1. This chapter describes the current profile of Spain from the point of view of its constitutional values and its geostrategic position as an European country with a vocation both Atlantic and Mediterranean. It also highlights the relevant role of the economic security, the fight against climate change and the promotion of the culture of national security into the educational system in Spain. Chapter 2. Under the principle that the globalization makes us more vulnerable, it designates a common global space, cyberspace, maritime space, land space, and outer space as possible confrontation scenarios. As an emerging problem, the growing lack of the delimitation between war and peace stand out, due to the growth of hybrid threats, with a special reference to the manipulation of information. Chapter 3. This chapter analyzes, from the Spanish perspective, the challenges in the different regions of the world, identifies 6 areas of special interest for Spain. First, Europe. The continent is a geostrategic space, and the European Union as a model for Spain. North Africa and the Middle East. Area of great instability. The Mediterranean Sea is a strategic area for the great world players and hit a highlight importance for Spain or the North Africa for the control of migratory flows. 3. Sub-Saharan Africa, growing area of vast resources and a risk of social fragmentation. It points from the Horn of Africa, the Sahel, and the Gulf of Guinea as an area of conflict. Latin America, Spain historically has been a bridge between Europe and America. Asia Pacific, focus of growing interest with China, with a global actor, and North Korea as a focus of insecurity. Chapter 4. This chart identifies the main threats and challenges for Spanish national security. Now we are dealing with the threats. First, armed conflicts and the increase of the military projection capabilities. Two, international terrorism. Three, organized crime and its relation with the migration crisis. Four, proliferation of weapons of mass destruction. And five, espionage. Now, challenges. Economic and financial instability, energy vulnerability, irregular migration flows, emergency and catastrophes, epidemic and pandemic, effects derived from climate change. These threats and challenges take place in a global common spaces, such as maritime space, airspace, and cyberspace, in which the absence of jurisdiction control by the states makes it difficult to identify the perpetrators of the attacks and difficult to assess threats due to the weak existing regulations. Chapter 5. This chapter establishes five general objectives that guide the state action and identify 15 areas to which in a particular objective is assigned, and a series of specific lines of action to achieve each of these objectives. In order to not exceed the limits of this intervention, we only refer to the global and particular objectives. General objectives: develop a comprehensive crisis management model, promote a culture of national security, promote the good use of global common space, boost the security dimension on technological development, strengthen the international projection of Spain. How particular objectives it makes: ensure the defense and security of Spain, neutralize the threat of terrorists, neutralize the threat of organized crime, combat the proliferation of weapons of mass destruction, defend the strategic, political, and economic interests of Spain, develop a cyber security system, promote the security in the maritime space, safety of air and outer space, protection of critical structure, harmonize balanced economic growth, diversify energy sources, control the migratory flows, consolidate the national civil protection system, security against pandemic and epidemics, and finally, conservation of the environment. These initiatives are: complete the crisis management model with a national scope, approve a comprehensive national security culture plan, address the design of the national strategic position regarding the governance and use the global common space, creation of the National Aerospace Safety Council, review the National Maritime Security, National Security and Energy Security Strategies, prepare the National Aerospace Safety Strategy, establish the National Security Council. But before we say goodbye, let me introduce some brief conclusions. Spain is heading toward the second decade of the 21st century, assuming that its geographical position and its obligation are relevant. A reliable member of both NATO and European Union require that the global threats be addressed by a comprehensive, coordinated, and cooperative responses, and the use of all kinds of capability, civil and military. And it's worth underlining the proposal to create a culture of national security between the Spanish population. Finally, I will want to end with a reflection in the form of questions related with the possible evolution of the national security concept. Can you imagine a not too distant future in which the traditional division between the Ministry of Internal Affairs as head of the state police forces and the Ministry of Defense as head of the armed forces disappears? Thank you very much for your attention.